Hello, welcome to DPV Technology. In this video, we will learn how to interface L293D Motor Shield with Arduino. Here is our L293D motor driver board. You can buy it from the website www.dpvtechnology.com at best price. Most of the cases, motors require more current. The output current from the Arduino pin is very low, and it cannot run motors those require high current. To solve this problem, a motor shield is used. With the help of this L293 motor shield, we can run 4 normal DC motors, 2 unipolar or bipolar stepper motor, and 2 servo motors. In this video, we will learn how to run DC motors with this shield using Arduino microcontroller. This motor shield has 2 5-pin screw terminals. The first 2 pins are marked as M1, where we can connect a DC motor. Then these last 2 pins are marked as M2, where we can connect another DC motor. The pin in between M1 and M2 is the ground pin. Similarly, in this side, we have M3 and M4 for another 2 DC motors. In this side also, the pin in between M3 and M4 is the GND pin. And we use these 2 ground pins when we use a stepper motor with this shield. One stepper motor can be connected to these 5-pin screw terminals, and the second stepper motor can be connected to these 5-pin screw terminals of this side. These header pins are used to connect 2 servo motors. Now we can connect a maximum of 4 DC motors having voltages between 4.5 volt to 25 volt and maximum current to a single motor 0.6 ampere from the shield. We can directly insert this shield into the Arduino pins. The module has an external power supply pin. The motor controllers on this shield are designed to run from 4.5 volt to 25 volt. This may be different for different manufacturers. Check the details from where you bought the shield. If we use these external power supply pins, then we have to strictly follow any one of the following 3 rules. First, if we want to use a single DC power supply for both Arduino and motor shield, then we can use a DC jack on the Arduino. Or we can use a DC source to the external power supply pin. We can use a 9 volt or 12 volt battery to connect to external power supply pin. But don't use both DC jack to Arduino and an external battery to motor shield at the same time to power. In this case, don't use a battery more than 12 volt to the external power supply pin of the motor shield. Secondly, we can power up Arduino through USB and motor shield through a DC power supply at the same time. That means we can use both USB to Arduino and external power to the shield. But in this case, we have to remove the jumper from the shield. In the third case, if we would like to have 2 separate DC power supplies for the Arduino and the motor shield, we can power up Arduino through DC jack and the motor shield through a DC power supply at the same time. In this case also, we have to remove the jumper from the shield. The reset button is nothing but Arduino's reset button. It just brought up top for convenience. These are external header pins that we have connected for different purpose. Now let us connect 4 DC motors quickly. You can use a single DC motor or more than that according to your requirement. Now to use this shield, we have to download the Adafruit Motor Shield library from GitHub. The link is given in the description of this video. After downloading the zip file, you have to unzip it and place it into the Arduino library folder. Now open the Arduino IDE and copy and paste the code. Link is given in the description of this video. Now upload the code. Here we can see the motors are running in forward and backward directions. The video link of the explanation of the code is given in the description of this video. You can go and watch the explanation in that video. Thank you. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can buy electronic components, projects, modules, board, sensors from the official website www.dpvtechnology.com. Thank you.